All right, we're back. I'm gonna try this with push to talk so that you're not constantly hearing noise, which I should have done a long time ago. Let's see. I think I was solving this puzzle over here, and I was being a little bit confused by the fact that I can see it, even though the water level is supposedly right here? Anyway. I don't suppose I have much of an option except to lower the water. Can't get lower than this. I don't think there's any other lights in here, at least I haven't found any yet. So I guess let's just raise the water up again and look from that angle. This isn't actually a good angle. So I don't think it is. Oh wait, I should look from here I guess. Alright, I should lower it again. Starting from the bottom, make a little T-shape and then go up around to the top. There we go. Alright, next one is this one over here, which looks fairly easy to do. After that, I think I just need to do this thing on the wall. Let's raise up the water again for this. it was worth a shot. I don't understand how to get at the right angle for this. So I need to go all the way down, then all the way up diagonally, then skip one, and then sawtooth. What was that? All the way down diagonally, all the way up, skip one, and then sawtooth. All the way down, all the way up diagonally, come down, skip one, sawtooth. Feeling pretty good. Right about here. Oh, did I get to the box? No, I didn't. I did get to the elevator shaft thingy, though. There's a lot of light around here, and these are all curved, so these should be easy, right? Right? Right?
Hello.
Missing that little nub up top. Oh, this could probably be tilted or something. What? What happens if I drain the water in here? It's already drained. Darn it. Well, I need to be able to tilt this, and I can't very well use this elevator until I've activated this puzzle here, but I can't solve this puzzle right now. So what am I missing? I could pick stuff up and move it. Oy. Ah. That's what I'm missing. You send it up without yourself, you'll ask, because I wanted to get to this door. Oh, shoot. Okay. Mistakes have been made. Well, I guess I have to take the long way out of here. I thought I could be sneaky. Should really put in a button to call the elevator back. That would have been way more convenient than having to run through this entire place backwards. I'm surprised I still remember which way to go. To the beautiful desert. Wait, there's stuff over here too. This game is so distracting. And really bloody pretty. I mean, wow. Oh, sick. That was a second laser. Nice. Nobody told me this game had lasers in it. I would have totally played it way sooner. More lasers. Oh, yeah. So I realized what my mistake on these trees were as I was editing the last video. I'm saying the words in the last video. I don't see any, obvious signs of what the branching pattern. Obvious signs of what the branching pattern is. Obvious signs of what the branching pattern is. Look, it's like visible. God, it's staring me in the face and I didn't see it. Okay, so anyway, let's check this out as well. So that the missing branches are honestly just to help me determine what side of the tree to look at it from. In fact. So let's solve this one now. One big branch on that side, yep. So let's see. That's the last one on the top. Jeez, way easier than I thought. How about this gate now? Yep, it opens for me. Missing branch is on this side, so I actually have to look at it from here. So it's actually the second... So actually, let's use that binary identification system. It's 1001. 1001. Nice. Alright, let's look for the broken branches. Okay, so this should actually be easy because the apple must have been where the extra broken branch is, because there's only two branches missing from here, right? Nope, there's three. There's that one, there's that one, and there's that one. Alright, well, two broken branches on the same stem, main stem, are on this side over here. And is there anything on the floor? I love this game. It establishes expectations and then it breaks them for you. Makes you think about it more. I'm like expecting to see an apple, but there is none, so where would the apple be? Signs of an apple. Ooh, look at this X made of flowers. I wonder what that could mean. Oh, there's a lot of stuff over here that I haven't seen yet. Man, okay. So this branching pattern actually looks inconsistent to me. Does it? No, it's always missing stuff at the end. Am I looking at it from the same angle? What might indicate that an apple was there? Oh man, this is frustrating. I was like, oh, I totally got this. I got this, you guys, you got it. Just gotta look for the apples. But look, there's no more apples, so what do we do? And there aren't actually that many possibilities to try, but I think that's a stupid way to solve this puzzle, especially now that I know it's possible. Okay. I'll go around here. There might be more clues here, except there aren't, because that gate's still closed. What's this now? How is this supposed to be a difficult puzzle? Maybe there's something I still don't know about it. Nope, it was easy to open. And it takes me down into the tunnels again. You can choose which direction the windmill turns. Does the windmill even turn? Ooh, it turns this way. I don't think it's in a plane where it can intersect that beam. doesn't look the same as the hexagon that we saw earlier, though. There's no starting point on the edges. What a shame. What more can I do over here? Oh, that's curious. How is it even possible to solve this? Hoo-hoo-hoo. Wait, did it just... So these little triangle symbols have to have like two sides covered or something? That doesn't make any sense. It's not possible to solve it. Is it? More mysteries. I guess I'll have to come back to them later. I really like the non-linearity of this game. It doesn't make you feel stuck even when you can't get a puzzle. Okay, so I guess it was actually...
Well, that's no better a solution than any of the others, is it? So,
no.
In the end, have we learned anything from this look at why the world turned out the way it did that's of any use to us in our future? Something, I think. That the key to why things change is the key to everything. How easy is it for knowledge to spread? And that in the past, the people who made change happen were the people who had that knowledge, whether they were craftsmen or kings. Today, the people who make things change, the people who have that knowledge, are the scientists and the technologists who are the true driving force of humanity. And before you say, what about the Beethovens and the Michelangelos, let me suggest something with which you may disagree violently. That at best, the products of human emotion, art, philosophy, politics, music, literature, are interpretations of the world that tell you more about the guy who's talking than about the world he's talking about. The stuff that goes to build up a... would be to recognize within yourself the ability to understand anything. Let me suggest something with which you may disagree violently. That at best, the products of human emotion...
So that's what that paper was about.
Philosophy, politics, music, literature, are interpretations of the world that tell you more about the guy who's talking than about the world he's talking about. Second-hand views of the world, made third-hand by your interpretation of them. Things like that, as opposed to this. Know what it is? It's a bunch of amino acids, the stuff that goes to build up a worm or a geranium or you. This stuff's easier to take, isn't it? Understandable. Got people in it. This, scientific knowledge, is hard to take because it removes the reassuring crutches of opinion, ideology, and leaves only what is demonstrably true about the world. And the reason why so many people may be thinking about throwing away those crutches is because, thanks to science and technology, they have begun to know that they don't know so much, and that if they are to have more say in what happens to their lives, more freedom to develop their abilities to the full, they have to be helped towards that knowledge that they know exists and that they don't possess. And by help towards that knowledge, I don't mean give everybody a computer and say, help yourself. Where would you even start? No, I mean,
where would you even start, indeed?
Trying to find ways to translate the knowledge, to teach us to ask the right questions. See, we're on the edge of a revolution in communications technology that is going to make that more possible than ever before. Or, if that's not done, to cause an explosion of knowledge that will leave those of us who don't have access to it as powerless as if we were deaf, dumb, and blind. And I don't think most people want that. So what do we do about it? I don't know. But maybe a good start would be to recognize within yourself the ability to understand anything, because that ability's there, as long as it's explained clearly enough. And then go and ask for explanations. And if you're thinking right now, what do I ask for? Ask yourself if there's anything in your life that you want changed. That's where to start.
Curiouser and curiouser. This game is kind of motivational too, I guess. Well, there's a lot of stuff in those tunnels, aren't there? Well, I still don't know how to get to these through those doors. And it currently seems impossible to me, so that's usually a good time to try again later, I guess. I know how to get down here now. At least one of the ways to get down there. That's really interesting. Wonder what purpose that serves in the grand scheme of the game. Setting the windmill turning. Notice that one of the blades is broken, I'll bet you. Yeah, it's probably not that important, but I've noticed it, so now I'll remember it. Let's go back to this tree. Should I just brute force this? Feels like a shame after all I've done. Is there any indication, like on the floor? Did the apple fall? So I think I'm actually already looking at it from the right angle. Based on which branches are broken. Let's look at the texture maybe. These scratch marks, they go up all the way up on the side too. I don't think that's significant. It's probably not significant. Okay. Let's look for other rules. I don't think it's ever next to another broken branch. Or it hasn't been so far anyway. It's never been directly next to one. It's been on the same main stem as one before. Same with here. Alright, so let's see. This one. This one. So it can be on the same main stem as a broken branch, but it can't be within, like, two nodes of a broken branch, I think. So, let's see if I can use that to solve it. I don't even know if that's the right rule to follow. So it can be on the same main stem as a broken branch, but that means I can't take this one. That means, I assume it's one of these four. Okay, that was just... what? I don't actually know why that's the answer. I just kind of randomly tried that one. Is that the same answer as the very first one? It's slightly different from the very first one. Ah, damn it. Now I feel bad. Maybe it just can never be one of the branches. Go away, Duolingo. It just can't. So it can't be this branch over there. It can't be... nope, I have already ruled out that theory. Oh, whatever. I'll come back to that eventually. Or maybe somebody in the comments will explain if anyone's even still watching these. Ooh, apples. They're fresh. Someone was here recently. And bonsai trees. And... ooh... I appreciate this. But now I don't actually know... that's the missing apple, isn't it? That's where it went. Because there's one of the broken branches along with the apples. Oi. Okay. So there wasn't actually much point to coming up here, but this is a pretty place to stop. Let's call that a day. Catch you later, you lovable nerds.